wondering aloud how we feel today. Last night sipped the sunset, my hands in her hair. We are our own saviors as we start both our hearts beating life into each other. Wondering aloud, will the years treat us well? As she floats in the kitchen, oh, I'm tasting the smells. Of toast as the butter runs, then she comes, spilling crumbs on the bed. And I shake my head. And it's only the giving that makes you what you are.
Now that song there, is that a song that you wrote yourself? Is this an older tune or is this a new tune?
That's one of mine and Dan's songs.
No, we're going to claim that one. That's ours now.
JT. That's right, so awesome. Yeah.
Cool. If you could expand a little bit on the instrument you guys are playing here. I know, I'm sure they're chosen specifically for, are they kind of just, do you have a random draw?
This belongs to Sam Walsh, the sound engineer.
Okay.
To borrow it. So he reluctantly let me, no, he didn't. All our gear is somewhere else. So but Dan carries his acoustic with him. So that's his own guitar.
This comes to the hotel room. Yeah. This sort of lives with me. We're looking for a little guitar, but this is a Taylor GS Mini. Just looking for a little guitar to take around on the back between shows in hotels, especially when you've got days off. And then it was a question of, well, you know, if you spend a little bit more money, you can get this nice one here. Mm. Yep.
And this one's just a cheap and cheerful bottom of the range Martin travel guitar, but
just
very, very nice.
It's just wonderful. It's a marvelous instrument.
But it's a Martin. Yeah, even there.
They're both marvelous instruments.
And do you guys have any instruments at home in your set that are specific, that are your favorite? Any guitars you've had that are just your go-to if you're going into a situation and you just want one guitar with you?
Oh, one. Well, we tend to use PRS on the road.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We all use PRS. I use Soldano and Dan's got a Hughes and Kettner. Yep. We take our gear everywhere, and the worst gig for me and probably for the others is where you're using a back line, because essentially the gear when we do our sound check, it's just to make sure that everything works. Mm. We know it's going to sound great, and people are paying money to hear a great band play great, sound great, and I don't want anything out of that taken away. That, you know, that nothing must be left to chance. It's got to be the best you can. You don't have to want to fight anything. You just want to know that you've got great gear, great setup.
What's the oldest guitar you got? Do you have any from back in when you kind of were first getting started?
I haven't got any guitars that are as old as me. But then we won't go into that. I've got a 1917 mandolin F4,
wow,
which is a beauty. Don't bring it on, it's just gorgeous. It sounds amazing. And then guitars, 56, 57 Gibsons, and I don't know. I mean, if I had the money, and I would just be covered in vintage guitars. I'd be like Joe Bonamassa. He plays a song on like a $250,000 guitar,
right,
and then the next song he's got another $250,000 guitar. But and great, you know, that they should be played. And I've been to museums, and that they don't belong on a wall behind a glass case. They need to be played. But essentially, I love all guitars, whether they're new, old, and Dan's the same. You know, we love Telecasters and Strats and
yeah, they've all got their own voices, and especially on records when you can, they're very flexible. On the road, you might want something a bit more consistent, and also we're not quite diva-ish yet, where we have our wardrobe of guitars.
Yeah.
Not yet.
Yeah.
That's coming. Yeah. That's coming. I want one per song, but right now.
Well, I loved it. Tull did a huge tour, and Peter Frampton was the support band. And I mean, I think Peter Frampton spent all of his gig money on the crew and the set, because everybody had their own personal roadie. Uh-huh. Now, I mean, there was a crew to set up the gear, and they had a personal roadie just to tune guitars and change strings, and they all had, it's like immense, like 40, 50 guitars. It's silly, but it must be very nice to be able
to
do that.
Can't even play that in one show, maybe like a week of heavy touring, you could play one of each.
It was nice though.
Dan, do you have any old school guitars, anything back in your personal trophy case that you're really proud of?
I've got my lucky find was a 74 Les Paul Custom, which I do value, but it's a bit weathered and grumpy. It doesn't like being on the road very much. It doesn't like rattling around.
We're a bit weathered and grumpy.
Yeah, a little bit. But yeah, apart from that, it's very special. It sounds great, and I love recording with it, and it does play well live, but it doesn't like planes, trains, and automobiles at all. It does not travel well.
You had mentioned some of the bands you grew up listening to, and those were a lot of bands that were around the area of Jethro Tull. What was do you remember when you met Martin and you guys kind of started jamming? Were you thinking like, oh my gosh, this kind of, you know, maybe when I was a kid I foresaw this in a dream, like I'm going to be jamming with a guy I listen to, and here you are, jamming with you guys.
Can I answer that question?
By all means.
No, at all. Which is good. I don't want any of that.
But it's interesting because
Is very independent.
It was all very friendly, but when we were learning, when we were playing little acoustic gigs together, I'd be learning Tull stuff that hadn't really been played for sometimes 30 years. I haven't heard that played live for 30 years. So my introduction to the material was very deep cuts and stuff. And that's cool, because when we play stuff, people just haven't heard it in a while, and certainly haven't heard it like also in the way we're doing it. Mm-hmm. So it does feel a lot more like our own. Well, it is. It definitely is, because it's just very different.
You remember when you and Ian met each other, and you guys kind of decided to jump into to the music and things.
Tull was a band for almost a year before I joined in the UK, and that's why next year's the 50th anniversary. But I'm going to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Jethro Tull in the States, which is from 1969, and to me that's when the music changed. It was a blues band in England, and the music that's commonly recognised as being Jethro Tull music started in 1969. But me and Ian both played flute, and we played in the same style without knowing of each other's existence. So I'd been playing flute since I was 15, and I played Roland Kirk blues flute. And so did he. So when we met, it was like, you know, a doppelganger. We had common ground, and I mean, essentially, the energy and the whole thing about Jethro Tull, from what I saw when I saw them play a couple of times, I just thought they got it right, you know, and I thought that's what I'd like. And so when I was a part of it, it was great, and we worked really hard. It sort of started a work ethic that I think we still continue. You know, we just work all the time, and it's not work. We're committed to what we're doing, and we don't sort of have a day off where you just sort of get away from it because you've had enough of it. If I get a day off, as Dan does, you know, writing, playing my guitar, I'm doing the same thing, but just not getting paid, I guess.
Now, how did you two guys cross paths and get together to form the Martin Barre Band?
I can't. Julie.
Do you think she did your first CD at the studio?
It was Mark Tucker.
Yeah.
It was through a producer called Mark Tucker, who lived in the same region of England that we do, and it was just one of those things. I think we met up, and we just came to visit and just hit it off. I suppose it was all very casual. Yeah. Again, I didn't really have a knowledge. It was all very personal. It wasn't a musical setup really, aside from the fact that Mark was like involved.
Yeah.
It was all very. very casual. And that must have been over it. That is over a decade ago.
Yeah, but we came from different directions, so you know it was good. You know, I like contrast, and I like somebody to have their own personality and their own input. Mm. And I don't. And until people would come and go, and you know the new keyboard player would have to learn all the keyboard parts from the guy before and the guy before him, and it was all a bit antiseptic. You know, I don't like. Or I wouldn't like to be that sort of a person where you just step into somebody's shoes and you've got to do exactly what they did. Yeah. It's not very satisfying, I don't think, musically. But the way we've evolved, it's everything goes into the cooking pot. You know, we've played Dan's songs on stage, and we've done, you know, if Dan comes with an idea for a song, maybe Government Mule.
Exactly.
If it's cool, we're going to play it. Mm-hmm. And that's a great thing that we can do. Anything we want to, essentially, because it sounds great, and it could, you know, we do Beatles songs, we do blues, that we don't have any restrictions at all. But the one thing it has to be is fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we get a lot of kudos because Porcupine Tree. There's a track called Blackest Eyes. Some of the stuff we play is really just like left of field, but because it's us doing it in our way. It all feels like there's nothing alien in the set, or there's nothing. And the greatest compliment really is when somebody can come to the show. They're no doubt expecting Tull, but then we'll throw in this Government Mule track, that Thorazine Shuffle, or the Blackest Eyes track, Porcupine Tree, and people love it because it's just another. It's something new to them that they really weren't expecting, and it keeps it fresh for us too. Mm.
Have you guys played or done any playing with Warren Haynes or any of the Government Mule guys? I know you say you're familiar with the music, obviously. Yeah. They're really a great band. I like seeing them.
Absolutely, yeah. Well, Government Mule supported Tull a few years ago. They were the support band.
Oh, wow.
Hilariously. So, I know him. I'm a big fan of his. So, yeah, we bumped into him in an airport, I don't know, maybe 5-6 years. I can't even think, but... Yeah, it's the sort of person, if you bump into him, it's really nice. Mm. He's a nice guy, and I've got a lot of respect for him.
You can certainly pick him out of a crowd, too.
Seeing him out there, he's... You can pick him out of a crowd in an airport. That's Warren Hayes. Hey! It's me.
Excellent. Gentlemen, do we got one more song, or do we... we got the time?
We could do, like, the first verse of Nothing to Say.
Yeah, that'd be cool. We've never done that before. Yep. With a riff.
From the beginning, yeah.
Every day there's someone asking, what is it that you do? Should I love or should I fight? Is it all the same to you? No, I say I have the answer proven to be true. But if I were to share it with you, you would stand to gain and die to lose. Oh, I could not bear it, so I've got nothing to say. Nothing to say. Nothing to say.
Absolutely fantastic. This is AM 1060 WHFB. We have the part of Martin Barre Band here. You can get the full piece at the livery tonight. And you guys are going to be starting right about 8 o'clock, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Sounds right.
Excellent. Yep. So I want to throw out a quick note for you guys. If you guys are up there, if you guys are beer drinkers, they got a great selection up there. That's actually my spot. So
we're all teetotal, I'm afraid.
They probably get you some of that too, though.
Teetotal. Yeah, how'd you like your tea? Total, please.
It's good to know.
Awesome. Gentlemen, any final thoughts this evening? Again, I want to thank you guys for coming out here and hanging out with us for a little while.
Thank you for asking.
It's been wonderful. Yeah, thank you ever so much.
Yep.
Jackie, any final thoughts?
What can people expect from your guys' set tonight?
That's
do you want to give away any any songs you're doing? No.
They're going to have to get there if they want to know. No, I promise them that if they come along, it'll be a great night.
Yeah.
And we want everybody who comes to see us play leave with a big, big smile.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I promise that they will.
I'm sure they all will.
It's a great night. So a lot of rock. A lot of power, a lot of blues, no acoustics. Not tonight.
Not tonight?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Well, you can expect the unexpected.
Yeah.
I like it. Yes, yes. Even.
Gentlemen, thank you so much for coming in here. Check these guys out. Martin Barre Band Delivery tonight. Tickets are still on sale, so get on over, support these guys. Thank you so much for coming here today. Southwest Michigan is very appreciative of you guys hanging out with us. So I hope to see you again real soon.
Yeah, thank you, Nick.
All right. CBS News coming up in just a hot second, so we're going to get into that. And when we come back, we got more music lined up for you. So stay tuned.